welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to kick off my fall DIY projects. I am doing a DIY hand-painted doormat, and it is also a dupe for something that I saw and really, really wanted, but wasn't gonna spend $45 on. So everyone has seen these really cool doormats that are like the natural material, and they've got funny or cute little phrases written on them. They're very, very popular. They're also crazy easy to DIY. There is no reason why you need to go out and spend a ton of money on this, especially for a seasonal doormat, which mine is. I did make it pumpkin themed, and I'm not gonna have that out all year, so I'm definitely not gonna go out and spend a ton of money on something that's only sitting outside for a couple months out of the year. So for this project, all you're gonna need is a jute doormat. I picked up mine from IKEA, and the one I found was so big, I was actually able to cut it in half, so I have two doormats for the price of one, and it was only a few dollars. If I can find it online, I'll definitely link it below so you can check it out. Other than that, all I used was plain acrylic paint and paint brushes. If you are so inclined and you've got a Cricut and you're awesome like that, then you could totally cut out a stencil. I freehanded mine. I have taken a calligraphy class in the past, so I feel a little bit comfortable with the scripty writing, but it's up to you how intense or how casual you wanna do it. If you wanna freehand it, more power to it. If you need that stencil or you just want that security to make it extra, extra perfect, do that too. There are no rules here. So basically all I did was I laid out my doormat. I kind of planned out what I wanted with a Sharpie and kind of lightly sketched it onto the mat. And then I went back with my paint and started painting it in. I did find out that the best way to get really good coverage was to kind of dab the paintbrush instead of making strokes. That made it a little bit more precise, especially with the scripty font that can kind of get messy if you're just kind of like painting like you normally would on a canvas or any other project. So kind of like dabbing lines made that a little bit easier. And I just went over it maybe two or three times tops. And with my little phrase, "Hey there, pumpkin," I put it inside a circle because I already had a circle drawn on this mat from a previous DIY attempt that I never finished. Different story. But it was super easy. It took me maybe less than an hour. I let it dry overnight without, you know, stepping on it or anything. Put it outside in the daytime. I layered it over this black and white buffalo check doormat that I got from Hobby Lobby. Got it on clearance, so another couple bucks, and it looks fantastic. It definitely looks like fall. I've got it next to my Hello Fall sign, even though it's not even fall yet, but whatever, I don't care. It looks super, super cute on my patio. All I have to do is swap out my summer wreath for my fall wreath that I just got from Big Lots, and my patio will be totally set. At least until the pumpkins come out, and then no one is safe, because there will be pumpkins everywhere. But all in all, this project, super easy, super inexpensive, definitely saved a ton of money DIYing rather than buying. And I have another mat that I can go out and make for a Christmas mat or any other. I can make a regular year-round one. I could do a Valentine's Day one. I don't know what I'm gonna do with that one yet. But the point is that I have it and I got two mats for the price of one. If you like this project, make sure you give this video a thumbs up. If you have any questions for me, leave them in the comments below. And make sure you hit subscribe because I'm doing a ton more DIY projects. Holidays are about to hit, fall, Halloween, Thanksgiving, Christmas. There's gonna be so much content here, so make sure you hit subscribe and hit that notification bell so you can keep coming back. And if you want to, follow me on Instagram at ColorfulMegan for more day in the life behind the scenes fun stuff. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.